Good morning. This is Dr. Nemechek, and this is the first of our new video blogs. I'd like to talk about coat hanger pain. This is a very, very common issue with people with autonomic dysfunction. One of the things that happens with autonomic dysfunction is if this is your head, people have trouble pushing blood upwards against gravity into their head and scalp muscles and the neck muscles. And So if you have low blood pressure into the brain, people are tired and they can't focus, they can't concentrate, it makes you anxious. This is actually a fundamental part of the patients we see who have ADD. Once you fix that, their cognition issues and so forth go away. But you also don't get enough pressure and oxygen into the scalp and neck muscles. And this is a very, very common cause of headaches, migraine headaches, as well as neck pain and tightness. Now, this neck pain we call coat hanger pain because of the shape of the muscles on the neck and shoulder region, obviously, are like a coat hanger. And the difference between, so coat hanger pain is really, you can have just mild tension. You know, people, this is where they carry their stress, so to speak. It can be mild to very, very severe and disabling. And the issue here is, how do you differentiate this from other kinds of neck pain? Because some people might really have a herniated disc or a pinched nerve or a facet, inflamed facet up there. And one of the very simple ways to determine coat hanger pain from a real anatomical, mechanical source of pain is what happens when you're active. Because if you're having trouble generating blood pressure up to your head, the blood pools in your legs, all right? So the more you move your legs, the more pressure you get in the head and neck, and the less neck pain you have. So with coat hanger pain, the more active you are, the less neck pain you get, which is typically very different than if you have a pinched nerve, okay, or a herniated disc. Those patients generally get worse with movement, not better, okay? They like to sit still because if they're moving around, they're grinding the vertebrae around, maybe pinching the nerve even more and so forth, aggravating things with movement. Coat hanger pain gets better with activity. So recently I saw a gentleman, he said he could play golf for 18 holes and have no pain, yet if he took his 45-minute drive home after playing golf, sitting still in the car, his blood pressure drops, he'd have horrible neck pain by the time he got home. All right. So this is due to autonomic dysfunction. Typically, you know, you would always want to make sure your blood panels are fine because maybe severe anemia or some other things could mimic this. But once you have your basic normal blood panels, this is almost always a autonomic problem and is called coat hanger pain. And you would want to focus on restoring the nervous system rather than maybe some injections, chiropractic treatment or surgery that's unnecessary, because they might give you a little bit of relief at the moment, but they aren't really fixing the source of the problem. So coat hanger pain, think about it, gets better with activity, worse when you're sitting or standing still. Bye.